In this problem, we have a situation where we have a beaker, and in that beaker, we have liquid and we have vapor. And we have a combination of both benzene and toluene. And we're given that the pressure of the system is 150 millimeters of mercury, and the mole fractions in the vapor for benzene is 0.65, and for toluene is 0.35. And what we want to know are, what are the mole fractions of benzene and toluene in the liquid? So in order to solve this, we're going to use Raoult's law for multi-component mixtures, such that the mole fraction in the vapor phase of benzene times the total pressure of the system equals the mole fraction of benzene in the liquid times the vapor pressure of benzene at the temperature. We do the same thing for toluene, except we can rewrite this as 1 minus x sub b p toluene star at some temperature. So how are we going to solve for these vapor pressures? In order to do so, we're going to need to use Antoine's equation that says that the vapor pressure of a substance equals 10 raised to the a minus b over t plus c, where t is a temperature in Celsius. So every substance has its own particular a, b's, and c's. So here are the a, b, c's for benzene and the a, b, c's for toluene. And so we've written both the vapor pressure of benzene as well as the vapor pressure of toluene in terms of their A, B's, and C's. However, you might notice that both of them have a temperature term in there, and we don't have the temperature. So what we're going to do is, again, write our Raoult's equation, Y sub B times the pressure equals X sub B P star sub B, which equals 97.5. I just multiplied 150 millimeters times our 0.65. We do the exact same thing for toluene, which equals 1 minus x sub b, now p star of t, which equals 52.5. And now we rearrange these. So x sub b can be rewritten as 97.5 over p star sub b. And then we can insert that into our second equation such that 52.5 equals 1 minus 97.5 over p star b. And this is all times the vapor pressure of toluene. Finally, we can write this so the entire equation equals zero. And the reason to do that is we can use a solver, and what we're going to use is the one in Excel, so that we can solve for our temperature. And then from that, we can get our vapor pressures. And finally, we can get our mole fractions, which is what we're looking for. So let's take a look at Excel. So here we have an Excel spreadsheet. And if you look here, I have the A for benzene, the B for benzene, and the C for benzene, and the A, B, and C for toluene. So from that, I'm able to write the vapor pressure for benzene using these numbers, the vapor pressure for toluene using these numbers. And notice this temp term right there. This is eventually going to be our temperature when we use our solver. And finally, we have that equation that we used that we set up before with our vapor pressures of toluene and benzene. And so what we're going to do here is use solver. And so if you look here at solver, what we're going to do is we're going to set this equation equal to zero, because that's how we set it up, by changing our cell right here. And when we solve for that temperature, what we come up with is a solution such that the temperature is 48.22. Our vapor pressure for benzene is 253.4 millimeters of mercury, and our vapor pressure for toluene is 85.4 millimeters of mercury. And now, knowing this, we are able to solve for our mole fractions. So going back to our equations here, let's take a look. So we have over here that x sub b equals 97.5 divided by the vapor pressure of benzene, which is 97.5 divided by 253.1, which we got from our solver, and that equals 0.385. And this allows us to solve for our mole fraction of toluene in the liquid, which is just 1 minus x sub b, which is 0.615.